गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड फर्स्ट टू रोमन्स इन एक्सरसाइज 1.4 इन योर प्रीवियस वीडियो टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट नेक्स्ट रोमन्स थर्ड रोमन इन द फॉलोइंग इक्वेशंस फाइंड वेदर वेरिएबल्स एक्स वाई जेड एक्सेट्रा रिप्रेजेंट रेशनल आर इरेशनल नंबर्स सो दे गिव सम इक्वेशंस So you have to verify whether those are rational or irrational numbers. First one, third one. X square equal to 7. So they ask to find whether x, y, z represents rational or irrational numbers. So in the following equations, find whether the variables x, comma, y, comma, z represents rational or irrational number. So they gave some equations here by using the variables x, y, or z. You have to verify whether x, y, z represents rational number or irrational number. First one is x square equal to 7. So we have to check whether x is rational or irrational. That's why from this you have to find x value. When I was transposing square to the right side, it becomes square root. So x equal to square root of 7. We know that 7 is a non-perfect square number. Square root of non-perfect square number is always irrational number. Therefore, x is irrational number. Irrational. Now, next second one, y square equal to 16. Similarly, this also you have to do in the same way. From this y equal to square root of 16. We know that 16 is a perfect square number because we can write 16 as 4 square. 16 we can write 4 square. So it is a perfect square number. We know that square root of perfect square numbers is always rational numbers. So y equal to root 16 equal to 4. Here 4 is rational number. Therefore y is rational number. Next. Third one. Z square equal to 0.02. Third one. z square equal to converting this decimal number into p by q form, numerator is 2 by after point how many digits are there, 2 digits are there, so after 1 you have to keep 2 zeros, 2 by 100. So when you transposing square to the right side, it becomes square root. Z equal to square root of 2 by 100. So we know that root of a by b equal to root a by root b. So similarly here square root 2 by square root 100. So 2 is non-perfect square number. So square root is, we can write square root 2 only. Root 100 is, this is 10 square. So square root of 100 is 10. So root 2 is irrational, 10 is rational. Division of irrational and irrational is always irrational. Therefore, Z is irrational number. Next, fourth one. U square equal to 17 by 4. u square equal to 17 by 4. From this familiar cube, u equal to square root of 17 by 4, which is equal to root 17 by root 4. So here also root 17. In this root 17, 17 is non-perfect square number. Square root of non-perfect square number is irrational. So root 17 only by root 4 is 2. So u equal to root 17 by 2. This is irrational, this is rational. Similarly, irrational, rational is always irrational. So which is equal to, which is irrational, irrational number. Next, fifth one, w square equal to 27. W square equal to 27. So from this, w equal to, transposing to this side, square root of 27. We know that 27 is non-perfect square number. So square root of any non-perfect square number is always irrational. Therefore, w is irrational number. Next, sixth one, t power 4 equal to 256. T power 4 equal to 256. So from this, how will you find t? If a power x equal to b, how will you write from this a equal to b power? Transposing this power to right side, it becomes reciprocal 1 by x. So here t power 4 equal to 256, t equal to 256 power 1 by 4. So this 256 you can write, when you factorize 256 with 4, 4 6 are 24, 4 4 are 16. Again, 4 16 are 4 4. So 256 you can write 4 power 4. So which is equal to 4 power 4 whole power 1 by 4. So using the loss in exponents. So what is the law in exponent here? A power m whole power m you can write a power m. So here 4 power 4 into 1 by 4. 4, 4 gets cancelled. 4, 4, 1 is 4. Therefore, t equal to 4. 4 is rational or irrational? So, rational. Which is rational number. So, t power 4 equal to 256. T equal to 256 power 1 by 4. 256 you can write 4 power 4. So 4 4 gets cancelled. You will get 4 power 1. 4 power 1 is 4. 4 is already rational number. Therefore t equal to 4 is rational number. This is about third round. The ratio of circumference to the diameter of a circle, C by D, is represented by pi. But we say that pi is irrational number. Why? So, fourth one. The ratio of circumference to the diameter of a circle is C by D, is represented by pi. But we say that pi is irrational y. So this is the fourth question. So pi ni c by d ga represent chestunnam, but it is in the form of p by q. We are representing circumference to the diameter of a circle is pi, which is c by d. It is in the form of p by q. We can say it is rational number, but why we are saying pi is a rational number? Already this one is, once you see in your textbook, in page number 10. So in page number 10 they gave know about pi. So know about pi. Here they gave what is pi, what is the history of pi, why we are saying pi is a rational number. See, here they gave pi is defined as the ratio of circumference of a circle to its diameter, that is c by d. So it is in the form of the ratio c by d, that's why you can say it is rational. But so there does not exist a common unit to measure that allows us to measure both. So here this is circumference of a circle, this is diameter of a circle. So there does not exist a common unit to measure that allows us both. If you measure accurately, at least either C or D is irrational. So pi is regarded as a rational number. So there does not exist a common unit to measure both the circumference and diameter. That's why whenever you are calculating circumference of a circle and diameter of a circle, exactly those values, circumference of a circle value or diameter of a circle value, any one of these should be irrational. That's why we call pi is irrational. So this reason you have to write. So there does not exist a common unit to measure both C and D. C means circumference and D means diameter. So if we calculate exact value of C and D, C means circumference and D means diameter, any one of C and D is irrational. Therefore, C by D is irrational. Therefore, pi is irrational. So, when you calculate circumference and diameter of any circle, we can't measure a common unit for both of these, circumference and diameter of a circle. So, there does not exist a common unit to measure circumference and diameter of a circle. If you calculate exact values of the circumference of a circle and diameter of a circle, either circumference of a circle or diameter of a circle should be irrational number. So if any one of these is irrational number, means suppose if C is irrational number, then irrational by rational is irrational. If D is irrational number, rational by irrational is irrational. Therefore we can consider pi as irrational. So this is about fourth one.
Next, fifth problem. Rationalize the denominators of the following.
Rationalize the denominators of the following. First one, 1/3 + √2. Second one, 1/√7 - √6. Third one, 1/√7. Fourth one, 6/√3 - √2. So this is about fifth problem. We have to rationalize all the denominators. Already in your previous videos, I explained how to rationalize the denominator of any irrational number. So when you consider first problem, 1/3 + √2. What is the rationalizing factor of 3 + √2? Rationalizing factor of 3 + √2 is 3 - √2. So multiplying (1/3 + √2) = (1/3 + √2) into both numerator and denominator, we have to multiply with rationalizing factor. So 1 × 3 - √2, 3 - √2 by this is in the form of (a + √b) · (a-√2). What is (a + √b) · (a-√b)? (a²-b). So 3² - 2. 3 - √2 by 3² value is 9. 9 - 2, which is equal to 3 - √2 by 7. This is about first problem. Next, similarly, second one. Here 1/√7 - √6. Rationalizing factor of √7 - √6 is √7 + √6. Already these formulas I told you in your previous classes. What is rationalizing factor of (a + √b), (a-√b), √a + √b, √a - √b. For all these rationalizing factors, I told you in your previous videos. So that's why I am directly saying rationalizing factors, directly writing these rationalizing factors. So √7 - √6 rationalizing factor is √7 + √6. So by using this rationalizing factor, both numerator and denominator you have to multiply with √7 + √6. So 1/√7 - √6 = (1/√7 - √6) without loss of generality. That means without changing this value, both numerator and denominator we are multiplying with √7 + √6. Now this becomes numerator, 1 × √7 + √6, √7 + √6 by √a - √b · √a + √2. What is the identity for that? We know that √a - √b · √a + √b = (a-b). So 7 - 6. Here we can write that identity. √a - √b · √a + √b = (a-b). So √7 + √6 by 7 - 6 is 1. So any number, when we divide any number with 1, you will get same number. So √7 + √6 by 1 is √7 + √6. So this is about second problem. Next, third one, 1/√7. Here also for denominator, rationalizing factor of, what is the denominator? √7 is √7 also. So 1/√7 = (1/√7) into both numerator and denominator you have to multiply with √7. So 1 × √7 you will get √7 by √7 × √7. So what is a into a? A square. Similarly, root 7 into root 7? Root 7 whole square. Square root gets cancelled. You will get root 7 by 7. So this is about third one. Next one, fourth problem. Root 6 by root 3 minus root 2 by root 3 minus root 2. Here what is the denominator? Root 3 minus root 2. So rationalizing factor of root 3 minus root 2 is root 3 plus root 2. So root 6 by root 3 minus root 2 equal to, for this both numerator and denominator you have to multiply with rationalizing factor. So root 6 by root 3 minus root 2, both numerator and denominator you have to multiply with root 3 plus root. Now numerator becomes root 6 into root 3 plus root 2 by, when you observe the denominator, denominator is in the form of root a minus root b into root a plus root b. What is root a minus root b into root a plus root b? A minus b. So using that identity, you can write 3 minus 2. Here you can write that identity. Since root a minus root b into root a plus root b equal to a minus b. Now, multiplying these two. Root 6 into root 3, square root of 6, 3 is 18. Plus root 6 into root 2, root 4 by 3 minus 2, 1. You can write up to here root 18 plus root 4. Otherwise, you can simplify these two also. Here root 18 you can write, root 18 equal to 9 to the 8. Square root of 9 is 3. You can simplify this as 3 root 2 plus, similarly root 12 also. Root 12 you can write root 4 into 3. Square root of 4 is 2, we can write this as 2 root 3. So, it is